this?
It's this is a very fancy feature. It's a round double pane glass
and
with
round?
A safety glass on the top.
That's the real McCoy right there.
And I love this.
It's zinc.
It's zinc. Beautiful work. It's time to crack this egg and see what's on the inside.
Let's go in.
Let's go in.
Oh,
this is it. This is so cool. How do you say that in German? How do you say cool?
We use the same word. It's
you
cool.
You do? It's cool. It's so cool. It's a two-man lounge. I'm going right for it. I'm going right for it, man.
And I had this idea of this egg shell, which is basically a perfect structure to make you feel really cozy. Yeah, the interior of this egg house reminds me of being in the mother's belly.
This feels so much bigger, too, when you get inside of it. It's got a lot of volume, you know?
Yeah, you expect a smaller space inside.
The more I go into this egg, the more I realize what kind of a technical achievement Andreas has pulled off here.
If you don't take risk as a treehouse builder...
We won't advance.
Yeah, we won't advance. Some say a treehouse should be totally supported by the tree. And not in my definition, because it is not like a competition, a technical competition to bring as much load as possible into the tree. It is more to get as close as possible mentally to the tree, using the space between the trees.
I think I was struck by his definition of what a treehouse can be, a refuge that's up among the branches of the trees. I've been involved in treehouses for so many years, and listening to you summarize them so succinctly, it's given me goosebumps. Now I can say unequivocally that gorgeous piece of architecture that Andreas created in the egg is a treehouse, and it's unbelievably cool.
Yeah, let's go to the treehouse hotel.
And this is just the beginning. We've got two more Venning treehouses to go.